Hi everyone and welcome to Usitility. Well, we are on the way to discover how to run Mech Arena Robot Showdown on PC. As you can see, you are watching it on your screen. It will be possible to easily download and set up Mech Arena Robot Showdown and play the game on a Windows PC with gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and big screen. Then without further ado, let's go buddies. Before anything else folks, the first thing to do is to launch our main browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to the next URL I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type it, simply because there's the clickable link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We ended up here on the website of Usitility, at which we find here a in-depth outline on the way to download Mech Arena Robot Showdown on laptop or computer. We search down a little bit and simply click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on the link, we reach the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will load to play Mech Arena Robot Showdown on the PC. As you can see from here, we have several pros of using that emulator. So we will start downloading the Mech Arena Robot Showdown by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. Next step is clicking on it. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Here it is, here is located the download. It is a file we have to execute. What we have to do is to run the installer, okay, then we click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the computer. We have clicked yes. I minimize the browser to find the installer considerably better. The installation software is pretty simple. It contains two possibilities, install, and setup path. I will show you what setup path does indeed. We purely click on it. And so we see that we end up with here the path where in fact the emulator can be set up. If we prefer to modify this folder, we must click on that Browse button, so we pick another directory and set up the emulator wherever we wish. I am going to keep it by default. Then, I click on Back. And therefore I click on Install. Great. The installation begins and it will progress in the download of those megabytes that happens to be displayed on our screen. The moment you download it, it may be more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed might go faster or slower, based on your type of access to the web and depending on the data transfer rate of the emulator web servers. Right away they are going extremely fast. The download is completed, and right now it proceeds with the setup procedure. The setup will need a little bit more or less time depending on the strength of your computer. The more efficient it actually is, the shorter the software setup time and or vice versa. If we join the download and setup step, it may take quite a while, so show patience. It has now ended on my side. At this time, the emulator has been started instantly. As you can see now, down here, there's a progress bar that will fill up and once it gets into the finish, the emulator can be launched for the first time. Believe it or not, the emulator has already been started, here it is for the very first time. Before we continue on, as you can discover, it has made two app icons there on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon will be one we're interested in. At any time when we desire to run Mech Arena Robot Showdown on the desktop or laptop, we double-click on this particular icon and as a result run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance app icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or even nearly anything like this. The fact is that, it's an icon that we would most likely never ever work with. Let me do the following step, that is a must-have, and this is to log on to the Google Play Store. As can be seen, the Google Play is launched. Right here we need to log on. Currently, when we're there, we must absolutely execute this following step that is definitely mandatory. Therefore click on Sign In. At present it says, Checking Info. It could from time to time get stopped at Checking Info, that's why it isn't going to progress. In that case, you can attempt to log in after a number of hours, it's going to very likely be resolved. At present we are going to insert our email and password. The email address ought to be a Gmail email address as well as its corresponding password. As an example, you can use the same exact email address you are using at this moment in your YouTube account. Thus, I am going to provide my data and I will go back as soon as I have accomplished it. Voila, data typed in. This is Google welcoming us and presenting us their tools. We can consent to them by just clicking on I agree. Then, it offers us to save to the Google Cloud. You could keep it selected, it's going to build a backup of the data files on this device to Google Drive. I won't check it, you do what you want. We mouse click on accept. The Google Play Store is launched automatically and instantly. To set up the application, we have got to visit the emulator desktop for Android by clicking on the icon indicated green colored. At this point that we are on the desktop of this emulator, we can see that we find right here the Install Application option. We click on this button. On this page we have the game app. Why don't we mouse click now on the Install link that I am showing now in green. This action will start the software installation. At this point it is going to install the video game. It normally takes a while, or perhaps it could be amazingly quickly. That all will depend on our own connection to the internet. It's actually completed installing. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by clicking on this particular button I'm emphasizing in green, that allows you to run Mech Arena Robot Showdown for the very first time. We should click on that My Games option just above. I am already on the emulator desktop, and therefore we are on the way to just click that brand new Mech Arena Robot Showdown software icon that has been provided. That game is started for the first time. Here we end up with it. I can also press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to comment on the volume level of the emulator. This is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we will not use the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of this emulator. And also to enjoy the experience to the maximum, we could activate the large monitor, for which we have two choices. This one is the first one. We mouse click on that app icon which I'm showing in green. Thus the screen is maximized, offering one border on top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. If ever we desire to have fun with the video game using all the screen, we select this particular game icon. And as a result we would at present be enjoying the gameplay in 100% screen setting. To get out of the complete screen mode, just click the F11 key. And we might now be in standard display screen setting. At this point, I am going to demonstrate to you the computer keyboard mapping, and that is certainly rather enjoyable. That way we definitely will be able to operate the game app more effortlessly. The very first point is to click this computer keyboard icon. And right now there you will be able to get the required setups. I'll go ahead and put the standard settings, but if you plan to change this, you can easily do it without having problem. Obviously, the emulator is completely in our own language. From time to time it occurs that your emulator is started in the incorrect language, for instance, in Chinese. And so to set it in the proper language we click here to the cogwheel. So here inside of additional configuration settings, we just click the language drop down. We can easily pick the language we wish, English, Mandarin, etc. As soon as the language is decided, we would save, the emulator will restart, along with the video game. The next time we launch it, would of course be in the chosen language. Right now, there is another information that we will need to take into consideration, and this is that we will get a message from Google Mail reporting that a new electronic device has been connected to this Google account. It will certainly ask us if we're the people who have connected that device. Of course, we shouldn't get worried, considering the fact that emulator is emulating in Google Android electronic device. And in order to see which smartphone or tablet is being emulated, we visit right here, to the cogwheel, and we then click on it. Be sure you go here to the model choice. And right here we realize that the emulator is simulating a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for that training. I hope that you appreciated it, specifically that you thought it was useful. If that is so, give it a superb thumb up, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer all your remarks, concerns or suggestions. Let them in the comment box below. You could possibly also comment things on my Twitch channel. I actually do live streams every now and then. You get it below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Mouse click on any of these videos that are showing up on the suggestion of videos to watch, and let's have fun again in the upcoming videos. Bye.